Many milestones in human progress can be traced back to the city. When people convened, they talked, debated, and devised new ways to take on the challenges of the day. Think of the agora of ancient Greece, or the city squares in Renaissance Florence, the English public houses of the Enlightenment, or the Parisian salons of the 19th century. When ideas incubating in an individual's head have the opportunity to collide with others, sparks fly, and revelations are made. Given this collaborative and communicative nature, it's not hard to see why so many research universities and the great thinkers that populate them are located in major cities. Places like Harvard and MIT, Columbia and UPenn, Johns Hopkins, Caltech, Stanford, and of course UChicago are all located in cities. So, what is it exactly that makes urban environments so conducive for conducting research and producing revelations? First, let's talk briefly about the word research. When we hear research, it's easy to picture a bespectacled recluse in a white lab coat, endlessly staring at a beaker of liquid. Or maybe a group of scientists holding clipboards, watching a rat complete a maze. Sure, research can look like this, but there's so much more beyond the sterile laboratory cliche. Academic research covers every area of thought. At UChicago, research has explored how humans are basically fish, the effects of language on cognitive development, the ways social media and music have reshaped urban neighborhoods, and how the impulse to rebel could curb unhealthy eating habits. It has been the foundation for immensely popular books like Freakonomics, written by faculty member Stephen Levitt. Meanwhile, economist and Nobel laureate James Heckman is discovering how a child's early rearing environment can shape the rest of her life, from how much she earns to the strength of her immune system. All of this research stemmed from the urban base of Chicago, and for good reason. With a population of approximately 10 million in the greater Chicago area, there are people from all walks of life, from all over the world and all along the cultural spectrum. This gives researchers access to a multitude of diverse data points so that research questions can be answered quickly and decisively. This can make the difference between an aha moment that sits idle in a notebook and one that is quickly tested and uncovers the next cure for a life-threatening disease. Many cities in the U.S. can boast of a great museum, or a large multinational corporation, or even the headquarters of an influential professional group. But Chicago has them all, and to a high degree. From our extensive hospital system to our international financial institutions, from the headquarters of the American Bar and American Medical Associations to the country's premier particle physics laboratory, Chicago is home to a range of organizations that influence the world. Imagine being able to study the millions of specimens dating back centuries that are part of the Field Museum's special collections, or restoring the colorful brushstrokes of a masterpiece at the Art Institute. Or perhaps immersing yourself in an immigrant community and discovering how their cultural traditions have changed and adapted over time. Our city is a living, breathing laboratory for the arts and humanities as much as it is for the health, behavioral, and social sciences. For the student, the opportunities at a research university like UChicago are endless. Cutting-edge facilities, a broad range of majors, faculty who are passionate about their work and bring current research and recent discoveries right into the classroom, often with help from their own students. And let's not forget the multitude of internships, resources, and job opportunities right in our backyard. If all this sounds a little too good to be true, you're in good company. As UChicago grad Carl Sagan once said, extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence. We invite you to visit our great school and this great city and start doing your own research.